Hi guys! So whether you got your flowers in a nice bouquet or you got them from your garden, in today's video I'm going to show you how to make a beautiful fall wreath from dried flowers, and I'll show you how to preserve them. I'm Marlene and welcome to my home and garden channel.
So guys, these beautiful red roses right here were a part of my anniversary bouquet from my husband, and I wanted to preserve the memory, so this is a really good way to do that, as well as to use flowers from your garden. And these are my cone flowers right here. They started to grow a little bit funny towards the end of the season, so I said this would be a perfect way to make use of them. So guys, we're going to take a look now at the first thing to bear in mind, and that's when you're drying your flowers, make sure that you're holding them upside down so that way they don't flop over and they're going to hold the shape that you want. Also, you want to make sure that you're putting them in a cool, dry, dark place because the sunlight actually helps to discolor them. These are my hydrangeas that I reaped from my garden, and I did pretty much the same thing to them, and I could have picked them a little earlier when they had more green, but I wanted that rustic color. And these are the same cone flowers that I mentioned to you earlier, and I thought these would make really great fillers. And over here I have just a few little spikes that I took off of my salvia, and they have such a nice fragrance, guys, so I thought it would be perfect for what I was doing here. And this is a little wreath. I didn't want to have too large of a wreath because it's going on my pantry door and I don't want it to be overwhelming. And here I have a burlap bow as well as a checked one. And I think that combination works really, really well. And then guys, you'll also need to have your floral wire because you're going to be doing a fair amount of wiring here. And I just wanted to take a moment to say that this is a part of an open collaboration hosted by the Grace Life DIY Home Decor, as well as a glam queen of decor and a few other ladies, and I'll link their channel in the description box below. So guys, let's go ahead now and talk about the preservation. As you can see, you know, the leaves are falling. We're going into the fall season. Bear in mind, guys, that when you're choosing your flowers, not to use ones like these. They're very beautiful. They're at the end of the season, but they're very, very soft, so they don't hold up very well. These are impatiens. They actually hold up better for things like pressed flowers, so this is something that you could use them for if you wanted to preserve some of them. And as far as fillers go, like my rosemary here, this is very fragrant, so it works really well. It's very firm and it has all those little leaves that come out, so it's perfect for something like that. So you can use something like that if you have that in your garden. And let's go ahead now. We're going to take a look at how to preserve them, and this is what I actually use, guys. I actually use hairspray. And it actually helps to hold it together. It's not going to be perfect, you know, like a silk flower, because they're still a little bit delicate, but it certainly helps to make a big difference as far as preserving, you know, the shape and longevity of your flower. And guys, you know, I do my gardening videos on Fridays and I do my decorating videos on Thursdays, unless I'm in a collaboration with someone else. So guys, be sure to hit the subscribe button and tap on the notification bell so you can always be notified. You can see what I'm up to and you can decide if you wanted to, you know, see what was going on with that particular video. So once you spray them thoroughly, guys, you know, they should be wet like this when you do one side. And then when you have finished, you're going to flip it over, you know, after they have dried, and then you do the other side. So that way, you know, it really has gone in very well on it. So now that it's been dried, we're going to go ahead and get it wired together. So first we're going to wire the roses together, your main flowers that you have. Make sure you have your shear. I like to have it with a safety on there. So that way, you know, if any little ones come by that they'll be okay. And then we're going to go ahead and get the spray ones and put those to the back. And you just basically arrange them the way that you want. So I'm putting them back there. I'm not putting too many on at one time. And then you're going to go ahead and wire together. And if you know, you see any like damaged petals on the outside, just pull them off at the base and it will still look fine. You don't have to worry about it. So just don't, you know, be too worried if that happens. It's not a perfect science. And I'm going to go ahead and use my shears here and go ahead and trim it off. And guys, be sure that you have sharp ones because it's important that you do that. It's really nice and neat. And I'll link this one in the description box below, so that way, you know, you can always check it out if it's something that you need to have. And then you'll just basically go in, guys, and start adding in your other flowers. I like to put in my like my hydrangea here first. And you just, you know, kind of like tweak it to the best way that you figure it will give you that nice shape that you're looking for. And then you go in and you put in your you know, your other filler flowers. And you can always, you know, adjust it here and there to suit your likeness until you find it, you know, exactly where you want it to be. And I, you know, did add in a few more. And I'm going to be using these two ribbons to make a pretty little bow. So I made the burlap one first. And I'm just going to go ahead and make the bow with that one. And then after I've made it, I'm going to tie on the smaller one onto it. And then you'll see what it looks like. So you just make your little pinch. And again, and then you cut it and you wire it. And then you're just going to go ahead and add on the other one to it. And I'd love to see your comments, guys, as to, you know, what other color combinations you might have used, you know, since it is for fall, you know, what you think would work, if you would use one, just one ribbon, or what other color ribbon you might use. So here is a finished product, guys. I'm hanging it at my pantry door. I thought it came out really, really well. I really, really like it. And you can turn it in different ways. I think like a square one, like I was saying before, you know, would actually be just as perfect as this one. And I also went ahead and I turned it the other way just to see how it would look. So you could tell me which one you prefer, if you prefer it to be with the flowers more towards the base of the wreath, or if you think it looks better with it to the side. And you also have the option too of making, you know, you can do one spray on one side and a spray on the other side, so you have a little bit more on either side if you want it to be symmetrical. So I hope that this gave you some great ideas, you know, for a nice rustic farmhouse wreath for your home. Help to welcome in the fall season. And it can be for any occasion. It doesn't even necessarily have to be for fall if you're using, you know, more or less neutral colors. So I do want to thank you so much for joining me today. I thank you so much to all my faithful subscribers who keep coming. I hope you'll have a wonderful fall season with your family. And I hope you'll try this out. And have a wonderful day.